our society. We're built on a whole system, you know, that has been created to really fool our minds and manipulate us. You know, we really just need to take a time out just to really think about things. Just really think about things, you know, that we are programmed to do or programmed to think. We need everything that we have been given since a child is something that someone else has given us. We don't go inward to find a thing, to find anything really anymore. Schooling is a programming to what? Some occupation that they have listed somewhere for you to be. It doesn't matter if the occupation is a basketball player, football player, or just a medical assistant, or working in the information technology field. It doesn't matter. It's still something that they have designated for you to be, and it's written down somewhere. And it's even statistics and numbers on the revenue that you can accumulate from it, which makes it very interesting, to say the least. Even when you look at it, the music industry, think about the ones that they promote and want to be successful. It's always more so the younger ones, to the younger audience. Now, what do a younger person has to really give someone? 90% of the time. Now, what do they have to give someone on a mental capacity level? What can they, and we have adults that we go and we listen to this music, we buy this music, and we really be in tune with it. And these children, they don't even have a sense of the world yet. They're talking about things that as an adult of a certain age, we should be over that. We should be teaching others not to go down those paths and showing them what it leads to. Yet this is being promoted by other adults, quote unquote, adults with bad agendas in mind, whether it's money to, control the minds of the masses, which probably it is, and to really take complete control of our mind via these spells that they're creating. And it's easier to do it with the youth. Because a baby brings down one's guard. When I say a baby, I mean a child, a younger person. Someone that doesn't hold that type of stature that an older person should hold, a wise older person should hold. You know, they're not going to speak about the same things. It just gets us caught up in just like an endless cycle of destruction and ruining of our minds. Because we are under attack here. We are under attack here. Internally. And it's just spilling out externally onto the world that we are currently all plugged into. Like the things we should really be thinking about, like the endless possibilities the body, the mind holds, the countless things we don't know about body and mind. That should be the aspiration. That should be the task at hand. You know, it's a quote that's out there that said it's a lot of dead dreams in the graveyard. You know, take your time. Let's think about that quote. What dreams? What dreams are there in the graveyard? Oh, I didn't start this business. I didn't make this $5 million. I didn't create this legacy for my children. You know, I didn't fulfill this trip to Europe. You know, or whatever. You know, it's all these dreams that people are referring to in a sense of what the system gives you. It's never, oh, it's so much potential that's in this grave of the human body that wasn't discovered. The potential of being, the potential to go places within our experience here. The potential to love someone earnestly and honestly to the point you can read each other's minds. the potential to, you know, go to these planets while you're sitting on your balcony. The potential to use more than just 10 or 20% of your brain, but to activate 80 to 100% of it. You know, let's talk about the real things that we are losing when we come here. We just go by the system. That's the real things that's in the graveyard. Not dreams and things that could be taken away. You know, what about these bodies that we have? These bodies that these bodies are our houses. They are our land. They are our everything. Without a body, you don't do nothing in this world. And they want to take our bodies now. How? By taking our mind. A mind is more than just like a organ or a fleshy part within our head, a brain. It's not that. It's something more. It's something more than that. It's where the spirit dwells. Where the energy coexists with the soul. Where conscious reality is made known. And that's worth fighting for. That's worth discovering. That's worth spending every day of your life, you know, trying to fulfill. More to me than going to a Europe trip. You know, yeah, all this stuff could be done, but it should just be a different priority on those things to me. Because self-discovery, going about, when you go to these places where you want to travel and do things of that nature, go there for a purpose, not just to get drunk or just say I've been there. Go there with a purpose to experience the energy of that land, to experience the, the history of that land. See what's there, what governs this land within the invisible realm. Feel it. Ask yourself, why have I been allowed to be brought here? What brought me here? What in me brought me here? And it'll be so much more discovery than just getting drunk with your friends and taking some pictures to put on some social media page that they'll probably just put on your, what they call it when you die? Eulogy when you die. And they probably won't pick the right picture. You know? Just priorities.